How did I end up like this? Well...
What? Borderlands is coming to VR? That's amazing! I've wanted this since the first day I tried virtual reality.
A few moments later...
What? No multiplayer? That sounds stupid. Well, I'd buy it anyway. Borderlands is fantastic, even as a single-player game.
2 weeks later...
So, there are no DLCs in this version? Don't they know about the Skyrim Special Edition? It had everything! Well, I still need some good VR games. And Firewall has shown me how amazing shooters in virtual reality can be. So, I'm still hyped?
Eventually...
Why doesn't my character move? Move? Gearbox, how can you fuck this up so bad? Oh yeah.
I could talk for hours about what makes Borderlands a great franchise, but this would be way too long. So in short, over-the-top characters, a great sense of humor, a unique art style, smooth controls, a good interface, and one of the best multiplayer experiences in the history of ever. Coupled with one of the most addicting gameplay mechanics out there. Loot all the things! So, let us take a look why this falls short.
One of the biggest reasons this fails is because of the controls. You can either use a normal controller or two move controller.
To aim, you have to really aim with the move controller, which is awesome. You can even punch with the controller to perform a melee attack. This sounds immersive so far. Oh yeah, and speaking of aiming, how do you think you aim in this game? By actually aiming? Don't be silly. You push a button and a mini screen appears.
Yay.
With the PS4 controller, you always aim towards the middle of your screen, so you shoot at the stuff you're looking at. That is lame. I mean, it is VR. The whole point of VR is the feeling you are in the game. So aiming is something you expect and want from a VR shooter. So you want to use the move controller to get the best immersion. But that is the worst idea. Just look at the controls. They are a mess. And if you take a closer look at the move controllers, you see the biggest flaw.
Because the first thing everybody notices with these is they don't have any joysticks. And that's a problem.
In most games, the solution to the character not being able to move is by teleporting you. Click a button and the circle appears, release it, and you are in that position. It works sorta for these games, but risks motion sickness as well as disrupting the gameplay. Other games like Skyrim gave you the option to hold a button and you start walking in that direction. And that worked way better. Not good, but it was acceptable because the fights in Skyrim rarely getting out of hand and hectic. You can spot most enemies and most of them have to actually get towards you because they attack you with swords and other melee weapons. But in a game where grenades explode everywhere, psychos run towards you to explode as soon as they reach you, and everyone and their grandma having machine guns, where you have to sway from one side to the other to dodge incoming attacks, it is like the professionals say,
it's bad.
You can choose in the options if you want to only teleport, being able to teleport and walk, or if you are able to walk and jump. Yeah, jumping is only an option in this game. And there are an insane amount of hidden treasures with loot, secrets and even character improvements locked behind hard to reach jumping challenges. But nope, they fucked it up! Here is me going to a secret with the jumping enabled. And this is the same challenge with teleport. Yeah, not any challenge to get it. So, what is the point in having these secrets where you normally have to figure out how to climb to a position to reach a treasure chest or something like it? There isn't one! Just click a button and you are there. Or the game literally don't allow you to teleport where a quick jump would have saved your life. But that is only the beginning of the bad design choices when it comes to the controller. The menus are made for a joystick, and not being able to use one is really annoying. Here is a quick example of how to switch a weapon. You first have to open the menus with the left move controller. Then you have to aim with the left controller towards the option you want to choose. Hold the button and move the controller up and down to scroll through the menu. Then you have to aim at the item, press the button, hold it and move the item in the slot. Do you see how annoying that is for a single item? I found myself not wanting to get better loot just to skip this tedious menu. In a game where the whole point is to loot and try out new weapons. Yeah, if you see a new weapon, you can hold the button to swap your current weapon with a new one, without going through this. But if your old weapon was better, you still have to switch it back in the menu.
There is absolutely no reason this game should have these horrible controls if the PSVR has literally a gun controller with a joystick in it.
Maybe you can argue they cannot do this with the Gunzerker's ability to use two weapons at the same time. And okay, granted, being able to dual wield is freaking amazing with the move controller, but it is just not worth the rest of the controls. And if you use the PS4 controller, he aims both guns at the same target, so why couldn't this be made with the aim controller? In fact, the DualShock controller makes this game playable. With the move controller, your left hand is in 99% of the time just there, just hanging around, not doing anything. Yeah, you can melee with it, but it just looks bad. Not only are your hands embarrassingly tiny, but you also hold any weapon with just one hand. It can lead to awesome scenes where you shoot a pumpkin with one hand, but most of the time it just looks wrong. I found myself only playing with the normal controller, because the button layout on the move is just so terrible, it made it impossible for me to enjoy this game. But even with the normal controller, you have to choose if you are able to jump or teleport. Why is the teleport option even here with that controller? Being able to jump is necessary to follow enemies or just get behind cover, and I really don't understand this decision. Like I said, they got rid of the multiplayer part, without them really bothering to adjust gameplay mechanics that are solely made with multiplayer in mind. Or why are there still things like character skins if you never see your own character yourself outside of specific menus? Even abilities, which were fantastic in co-op, like taunting enemies so they attack you and not anyone else in the party, are still here and feel outdated. This game feels like they just copy-pasted nearly all mechanics without thinking about it. Virtual reality desperately needs multiplayer games, and Borderlands is one of the best co-op experiences ever, so this is a huge wasted chance. However, they implemented a completely new feature into this game, bullet time, or maybe I should call it badass time. I love this new feature. You have a new meter which fills over time and actually rather quickly, and with the push of a button, you not only enter bullet time, but you also push away every enemy near you. Pushing away enemies to run towards them, to aim a one-handed pumpkin at the head and make the whole screen go red in a gory explosion is an awesome feature in VR. Yeah, bullet time is normally a problem in multiplayer games, but why not share the bullet time and the meter? If one activates it, make it so all the characters use it at the same time, but shorten the duration. I would love to see this feature make a return in future titles like Borderlands 3. But again, the button layout on the move makes it really uncomfortable to use this awesome new feature during movement. To start it, you have to use the finger with which you move your character. However, it is a fantastic addition into Borderlands, so not everything is bad in this version. But the bad stuff is just so bad right now. I mean, look at the interface. We have a small minimap in the top right corner, and at the bottom of the screen is your HP, shield, bullet time, ammunition, and so on. I only realized there is a meter for the bullet time after around 5 hours of game time. It took me so long because the placement is horrible. To see these, you have to go cross-eyed. It is really uncomfortable because all these vitally important informations are nowhere near your point of view. To explain this a bit better, because you really have to experience it for yourself to understand. If you use the controller, the crosshair is where you are looking at. So, regardless where you are looking, these informations are always out of your reach. To see anything important, like your HP or even the minimap, you have to squint your eyes. There were so many times I ran out of ammo or grenades and I had no idea about it. Not really being able to see the enemy location on the minimap hurts as well. Then, there is the driving. Oh boy, my first experience with the cars in this version was this. What is this field of view? Am I inside someone's asshole? Thankfully, the controls aren't as horrible as I feared, but it still took me a rather long time to get used to the driving controls. And you can disable the tunnel vision in the menu, so you can actually see anything, let alone the scenery. And the environment is awesome to look at. It is still this unique cel shading-esque art style with all kinds of terrain and enemies, but now in 3D! It looks amazing and exactly like I imagined a VR Borderlands would look like. Being able to look at each weapon from every angle is a really nice touch as well.
I really wanted to like this version, but it just feels like every single decision is there just to inconvenience the player who wants an immersive virtual reality experience. I mean, I completed Skyrim with these and it felt amazing. Shooting a bow, slashing swords, it worked in this game, so why couldn't they make it work in this one as well? With the normal controller, it is okay, not great, but it is playable. But playable is such a waste of potential with this.
Not to mention, the best stuff about Borderlands were always the DLCs. I rarely laughed so hard in any game as I did in Tiny Tina's D&D game. But it is just not here. It is the bare bones minimum we got with this $50 game.
I am still midway in my first playthrough of this version, and normally I don't do these videos before I finish the game. But this is an exception because I played the original PC port for over 200 hours already. So if the game suddenly becomes amazing because they added all kinds of stuff, I make a follow-up video. Right now, I am deeply disappointed. I really hope for future patches, like aim controller support, multiplayer, or even the DLCs, anything at all. In the current state, I cannot recommend this game, regardless of how much I love the Borderlands franchise.